We stay on the ice in Canazé with the captain of the Great Britain ice hockey team. He's competing in his third University Winter Games, having previously represented Great Britain in Turin in 2007 and China in 2009. The Universiade in Trentino was the last for him.
Luke Piggott, I'm 27 years old. I'm the captain of the Great Britain University ice hockey team. So I started my studies at Cardiff University doing an undergraduate degree in medical biochemistry. I went on to do my master's following that, and then I continued into doing a PhD, which in breast cancer research. My typical day is I'll go to the ice rink in the morning, and we practice four times a week. So we were on the ice early in the morning, sort of, well, relatively early at 10 o'clock in the morning, and we practice for about an hour and 45. So I quite often don't get to the lab to do some research until about midday. But that just means that I have to stay a little bit later into the evening to make sure I get all my research done. It's not been too tough to mix. I mean, at times, obviously, the amount of time spent in the lab is a little bit of a strain. I've become a lot more organized over the years as a result of having to mix the two of them. And I think that'll really help me later in life as well. We practice four times a week. So that obviously puts a strain on my studying a little bit, but I was lucky in the sense that my supervisor and my coach, both very understanding people, so both of them were happy for me to do both careers so long as I was getting the work done both on the ice and both off the ice. Yeah, so I had a recent discovery, which was a novel therapy for breast cancer, and the work in the laboratory, we do a lot of work on what are called breast cancer stem cells. What that means is cancer stem cells make up a really small proportion of the tumor cells which are within the lump that you would typically find. And it's this small population of cells which is really responsible for the spread of the cancer to secondary sites, which is ultimately what would be for the fatality of the patient. So our work focuses primarily on this small subset of cells. I think one of the things which is common between the ice hockey and the research is teamwork. I obviously work with a team on the ice. It's a team orientated sport, obviously. And what a lot of people don't realize is actually research in the laboratory is a team effort as well. We have more than one person frequently working on the same sort of project, and we're all working together in the research environment to try and come up with these novel therapies. So I think that's one thing which is consistent across both of the two things. This is my third, obviously, time being to the Universiade, and it's always a great experience. You learn a lot of things, and we're playing against players at the top levels of the game. You can see from the game when we played against the Russians how good they were, how quickly they moved the puck, and I think you learn a lot just by playing against that caliber of player. The huge thing is just the experience of the whole Universiade and the environment, and being a part of something so big and such a great experience, I think.